This is my second time trying to film this video because last time my camera caught me off so many times and I rambled and I didn't know what I was talking about. Today we're going to do my top 10 products from W7. I don't have that many lip products in this top 10 because I think it can be a category for itself, because otherwise this will be like top 20 or something. I have a top 5 kind of for my lip products, so if you want to see a video about that, I will be more than happy to do that video. But right now it is going to be my top 10 products from W7, and W7 is a cruelty-free UK based brand. You can buy them in US, but I don't know where. I only know where in Scandinavia. If you don't know, I am a W7 ambassador, so that is why I have so many W7 products. I get them sent to me to test them out and give my honest opinion on them. And from my opinion and some other girls' opinions, that will influence if the product is going to launch in the shops in Denmark or not. I hope that makes sense. But yeah, this is my top 10, and I have tried to go through all the products, kind of products, I have gotten from W7, and it was very, very hard to narrow it down because there are a lot of good products from W7, but there are a lot of misses as well. So this is my top 10, and I actually have a bonus item. So because I couldn't choose. So yeah. So these items are not in order at all, but the first item I'm going to talk about is my all-time favorite product from them. So that is number one. No matter what. My number one product from W7 is their lip liners. Not everyone is a lip liner person, but I became one when I tried these. I can't live without a lip liner now because they're so creamy and they just make your lipstick last so much longer, and they are comfortable on your lips, so it makes you want to use them. These are the lip liners I have left. I have used up like 4, 5 maybe this year. You can see there is a very big range of colors, but my favorites are, let me see here. So my favorite colors are pink, red, and very nude. So these are the statement colors, I guess, for a lip liner collection, and I will always have these 3 colors on hand. The only color I don't have anymore is very nude because I actually used up the 2 I have. So, but I'm not going to buy it before I run out of lip liners, which will not be in the near future. The next item on my list are glitter eyeliners. These are the Metal Flash Metallic Glitter Eyeliners. There's one is silver, iridescent, holographic one, and then a gold. The silver one is called Glam Bam. The iridescent one is actually called Iridescent, and the gold one is called Glitzy. They're beautiful, and these can sting your eyes in for like 10 seconds when you put them here. They can be built up to a very pigmented eyeliner. I have tried that. Just Glitzy on its own, for example, it's beautiful. I often have iridescent on top of my eyelid, and on New Year's Eve I used this one all over my eyelid on top of a black shadow, and it was beautiful. Then we're going to talk about some of my favorite cream eyeshadows. I am a huge fan of cream eyeshadows overall. I always incorporate them in my looks if I can. I dream shadow cream shadows. So I have 5 here, and they are in different shades. Some are darker, some are lighter. My favorite one that I'm almost done with actually is Rose Garden. And these are just so pigmented, and they are creamy, they are easy to blend out, and they dry down really fast, which can be a problem if you don't blend it out right away. They stay on your eyelid and they make your eyeshadow pop a lot more. So these are very, very beautiful, and I hope that W7 released some more colorful shades because these are very neutral. The only one that stands out to me is this one in Heavy Metal, which is like a purple one. W7 doesn't have like a creamy primer, but they, so I don't have a full face primer from them, but my favorite primer they do have is the Pore Affection one. This is a pore minimizer primer and I have already gone through one. So I am working on a new one and I'll always have this in my collection. This is a very affordable dupe for any pore minimizing primers out there. I only use it here on my chins and on my chin and my forehead, because that is where my pores are the biggest and the biggest issue when I need to apply concealer and foundation. I don't know what to tell you guys about this primer because it's just a pore minimizing primer, but it really smooths out your skin so you can't see your pores. My favorite cream highlighters. It is the Strob & Go Strobing Sticks. These ones right here. This is in Moonlight and this is in Pink Light. It's beautiful. I have this one underneath my highlighter today on my cheeks. These are just really, really creamy pigmented and they are good at layering. You can lay it underneath and on top of powder after you have set your face and stuff, and these won't go patchy at all. They are amazing and I just really, really love them, and the colors are beautiful. If you're light like me, you can use both of these and they will be beautiful on darker skin tones as well. W7 is very affordable, so it won't blow up your budget at all because they are so affordable, but they are so great. And highlighters do last forever. They do. So this is a good investment. Okay, eyeshadow. This was a hard category because I have quite a few favorites actually from W7, but I do have some that you need to stay away from. That can be another video if you want me to do that. But if I need to recommend one kind of eyeshadow from them, it is going to be the Naughty Nine Pans palette. The Naughty Nine Nine Naughty Shades of Eye Color. They do have more shades. They're not crazy pigmented, but they are pigmented enough that you don't have to be careful. So yeah, I have Midsummer Nights, which is this one. It is so beautiful, which is one of my favorite palettes at all from them. And then we have Bangkok Nights. I haven't used this as much as this one. A mascara I absolutely love. It is the W7, obviously. Lastastic False Liquid Lashes. I have gone through this one. This is dried up. And I have gone through a mini size. And I actually bought it again. This is the one. It is yellow. And let me show you the wand. It looks big. But this is so good. It is just the perfect size, I think. I have tried a lot of mascaras from W7. I have only found this one and then the very vegan one, a white one that I really like, but I like this one better. This is the Genius Feather Light Foundation. I have just used this up in like August or something. It lives up to the name, Feather Light. It is so light on your skin, you almost forget you have makeup on your skin, which is so great. And this is a medium coverage, I would say. It doesn't cover up everything, but it does let your freckles or some acne thing show through your skin if you want that. So this is so, so nice. It comes with this rubber, which I'm not a fan about, but because it's so thin, it is a good thing. And this is actually a shade match for me when I am losing my tan. Not when I am at my palest, because then I'm just ghostly white. But it comes with a good shade range, actually. So, that's good. Then we have the Very Vegan Matte Bronzer. And I don't like when my bronzers are shimmery. So, of course, this is matte. And it's just a very nice bronzer. I don't remember if they have more shades than just this. This is called Sun-Kissed. Let me show you the right way. So this is the one. I love that it comes with this pattern. It is shaped like a tree. So this is the grass and then it is the tree crown there. It's so beautiful. And it comes with a mirror, which is great if you're on the run. I have it on today and I'm kind of heavy-handed with my bronzer. And it's not dark at all, even though it looks like it's dark. And this formula, it is a beautiful formula. It is so creamy and again, it's not as pigmented as you would think it would be. It's just the perfect shade. It's not too orange, it's not too red, it's not too cool tone. So I just think this is a perfect bronzer. And I have used this for like 1 or 2 weeks now and I'm excited. It's so, so good. The highlighter in the same range is called Nature's Glow and it has the same imprint layout thingy. It's just beautiful. And mirror, it has the same formula, it's just creamier. This does not enhance any texture on your skin. It's just beautiful. This is a more golden highlight if than, for example, some of these cream ones, but it is so beautiful. It's beautiful and I can use it on my very, very pale skin and it's not too dark. And I believe it is going to be beautiful on all skin colors. The packaging is so sleek and beautiful. It can be kind of bulky, but if you don't mind, this is beautiful. This line is amazing, except for the eyeshadows. Don't do that. I have not tried the lipstick, so I can't talk about that. But the highlighter, the bronzer, and the mascara is amazing from that line. The last one I'm going to talk about, which is my bonus item, and I couldn't include this as an item because I don't like the other shades in this range. This is the W7 Twist and Shape Brow Pencil. This is the one, and I have this one in blonde, and it is the one I have in my eyebrows today. It is skinny but wide at the same time. It has a perfect shape, I think. I love to use the wider side when I fill it in, and if I'm going to be precise, I love to use the skinny side. And it's twist up, I just love it. And it comes with a very hairy spoolie, apparently. No. And it comes with a spoolie, which is just great, so you don't have to bring your own. That is everything for this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed this, and if you want to see a lip product, version. Wow, brain fart. So if you want to see a lip product version of this video, please let me know down in the comments. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on maybe the lip product version or some of my other videos. I have done a palette bingo on this palette right here. It is the W7 Spaced Out palette. So if you want to see that, please stay tuned. I don't know if that is going up before or after this video, but you can subscribe and click the bell to stay on top of what I upload. So until my next video, please take care.